ask the department because still we don't know what is the format for that. I will ask the department. Take your seat. Okay, last class I think bending moment we had worked out AC calculation. $680 or $670 So in the last class, up to this bending moment, we had worked out. So next we'll go for the reinforcement calculation. So about x-x axis, we have the bending moment. So whatever this bending moment is there, for this bending moment, whatever the steel you provide, it should be along the long span, along this longer edge of the footing. Because we have taken, this is the critical section for the bending moment. And at this particular critical section, we know the bending moment, which is equal to 584 kilonewton meter. So what is the steel you get as per that mu xx, it has to be provided along the longer direction of the footing. So just go for the ASTX calculation. So I'll just put it as ASTX is equal to We know the bending moment. We know the depth, what we had assumed. So as per that, how much steel is to be provided. So here, the B value, we should not take it as 1000 because we had considered this complete width. So whatever the width we had assumed, so your B value in the ASC calculation, B is equal to capital B. And whatever the ASC you are going to get, that is the total ASC which has to be provided for a width of B meter, that is 1850 mm. So once you get that ASC, then you can get the number of bars, because whatever that ASC is there, it has to be distributed along this width. So you can get the number of bars to be provided in the footing along the longer direction, because we are taking this moment. Similarly, bending moment along YY axis, about this axis. So as per this moment, whatever the steel you get, it has to be provided along the shorter edge of the footing. And while putting that B value, so here B is equal to L. So when you go for ASC calculation, B has to be equal to L. So for this complete width, how much ASC has to be provided? Just go ahead with the calculations. Same formula, bending moment formula. Same bending moment formula. Mu equal to 0.87 Fy ASC into D. So that formula, or even you can use that simplified formula for the correct equation. That is 0.5 FCK by Fy into bracket 1 minus 4.6 mu. So now here going for ASCX means it is mu XX divided by FCK B into B square. So here B is equal to capital B. For this case, B is equal to capital B into B into D. And D is here, D provided 680 mm. So FCK is, I think, M20 is given, and FE 4 on 5 is given. So MUX, it is 584.8 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by FCK is 20, B is 1850, depth 680 square, this multiplied by 1850 into 680. Thank you. So how much AHT here? AHT is equal to 248384.9 m squared. So this AHT, so as I told in the last class, you have two options. Either you can get the number of bars or spacing. Right? So if you take this as AHT, you have to get the number of bars, which has to be provided for a width of 1.85 meters. Or if you want to get the spacing of the reinforcement, then this has to be divided by 1.85, means 1850. You have to divide it. And then whatever the AST you are going to get, that AST you have to use for the spacing calculation. That is, spacing is equal to small AST divided by small capital AST is there. So that capital AST will be this value, 2484.9 divided by 1850. Whatever the AST you are going to get, that AST you have to use. And whatever the spacing you are going to get, that will be per meter width. So here, two options. Whichever you feel that option, you can go ahead. So which option shall we go here? Spacing. Okay, now this AST divided by 1850. So what is your AST now? AST is equal to, sorry, not, it is not term. 1.85, sorry. Okay. No, this is per meter we want, is it? So it is 1.85, sorry, it is 1.85, not 1850. This AST divided by 1.85, because we want per meter. So that's why this has to be in terms of meter. So this is AST per meter, AST per meter, because this is millimeter per meter width. So here 1.85 should be in terms of meter. So after this, how much you will get here? 1342. Just check it out. 1342.43 mm square, it is per meter, because we are dividing this with meter, 1.85. So now we can go for the assumption of the reinforcement. So how much diameter of the reinforcement we assume for this? So as per the practical consideration, generally we provide minimum 10 mm diameter in the footing, minimum. Will not go below 10 mm. We can't generally don't provide the footing reinforcement as 8 mm. Because next below means it is 8 mm. Minimum 10 mm we have to provide in the footing. So we can provide 10 mm, 12 mm or even 16 mm based on the how much steel has to be provided. But not less than 10 mm. So if I provide 10 mm, again the spacing of the reinforcement should not be less than 75 mm. So what is the answer? Should not be more than 300 mm. So that condition, again, it will hold good for this column footing also, as we refer for the slabs. Minimum spacing, not less than 75 mm, and maximum not more than 300 mm. The same clause will apply here also. So here, if you assume 10 mm, what is the spacing of the reinforcement? If you assume 10 mm diameter, the spacing S is equal to, so area of one bar, that is pi d square by 4 divided by 1342.43, and per meter we want the spacing, that's why multiplied by 1000. So we'll get the spacing if you go with 10 mm diameter. If you go with 12 mm diameter, again the spacing will slightly increase if you go with 12 mm diameter. Just check it out, how much spacing for 10 mm? How much? 88. 58. So then as per the codal provision, it will not fit into the clause. because the spacing should not be less than 75. So we can't provide here 10 mm reinforcement. So we have to go for 12 mm reinforcement. So just to make it 12 mm reinforcement. So as per the clause, it will fit into the clause because it says that it should not be less than 75. But when I say 80 odd, we can make it to 80. We have to use the reduce to the lower round value whenever you go for the spacing. So we can make it to 80 mm. We should not make it to 90 mm. We should make to the lower value whenever you go for the spacing. But whenever you go for the number of bars has to be rounded off to the next higher round value. Because I had seen in the last test, most of you had rounded off to the next higher value for the spacing. But it should not be done like that. It should be rounded off to the lower value. So now here, as per the coordinate provisions, 12 mm will fit. But 80 mm is very close, and whatever the depth of concrete we have to provide, it is about 680 mm. So it is preferred to have some larger spacing. So as per the clause or the calculation, 80 mm is safe. But since the reinforcement are very close, the concrete is very difficult to pass through that mesh, because in both directions we have to provide the reinforcement in the footing, in the long span as well as the short span, we have to provide the reinforcement. So that whatever the openings are there, the mesh, it is about 70, less than around 80 mm. So that's why if it is more, then concrete will easily pass through that one. So numerically 80 mm spacing is correct, but practically we can go for the higher reinforcement and we can increase the spacing. So instead of 12 mm, if you go with 16 mm, what is the spacing? 149 means around 145. We can make it to the lower round value multiples of 5 mm. If you take, it is 145 mm center to center. This is quite reasonable. So 145 means practically it is around 6 inches. So around 6 inches, 1-1 reinforcement will be there in the footing. So this left to you, whether you can provide 12 mm, but you can't provide 10 mm because it will not fit into the clause, because the spacing will be less than 75 mm. So as per your requirement, you go ahead with 12 mm or 16 mm and get the spacing, and you get how much AST actually provided by rearranging this general equation. Actual AST provided and actual how much spacing provided, as per that how much AST you had provided. You just recalculate the AST actually provided. So here I will go with say 16 mm diameter. It is around 145 mm center to center I will get. So to get AST actually provided, so just recalculate the AST. So I will just put as AST actually in the x direction. I will just give the notation as AST ACTX actually in the x direction is equal to, I will rearrange the same term, pi d square by 4 divided by, here I will put it as spacing multiplied by 1000. So which will be slightly higher than this. It may be around 1400 or something. Just recalculate AST actual provided 1000. One three eight six point six three mm square. So this is the actual steel provided. Required is 1342. Because of this rounding of the spacing, the actual AST will be slightly higher than what is required. So this actual, why we required? Because we want the design shear stress, that is tau C value. And tau C value is 100 AST by BD. So for that, for check for the shear, we want actual AST provided. So now this is actual AST provided in the X direction. So similarly, you go for the steel provided in the Y direction. In the bending moment, which is there in the YY axis, it means the steel provided in the shorter span. So after this, you keep it. Next, you go for ASTY. ASTY calculation. So in this case, here it will be MUYY, and here FCK into BY is there. So B will be replaced with capital L, because whatever the steel we are going to provide, it should be for this width. So that capital B has to be replaced with capital L. So here it will be L. B will be as it is, but again, to the specific, this D will be get reduced, because this D, whatever 680 we had provided, it is along the short span. So along the long span, when we provide, your depth, again, it will decrease. Because when I put the reinforcement, when I take a cross section, first along the shorter span, and on that, the longer span. So what is the depth we had referred to the center? This is 680. But when we go for the longer span reinforcement, actual depth to the longer steel we have to get, as we had done in the two-way slab, dx and dy, d suffix x and d suffix y. But here it will not affect much. So that's why directly we can take 680 only. Because here whatever this depth we had provided, by shear consideration we had doubled it, 1.75 to 2 times. We had doubled it. So even if you take 680 here, it will not affect much. So here this will be 3700. This moment, ASTY, it is 292.4. This D is 3700, and remaining all the parameters are the same. So your ASTY, it is 1202.51 mm². So this is for the complete width of 3.7 meters. If you want again the spacing, divided by 3.7 now here. Because whatever this AST is there, it has to be provided for this much of the width, that is 3.7 meters. That is 3700 mm. So this divided by 3.7. So how much? 325. Just check it out, the calculations. Is it right? It's around 325. mm² per meter. So now in this case I can go for 10 mm. If you go with 10 mm, the spacing So it is around 240 mm center to center, which is within the limits. That is maximum limit is 300. So along the shorter direction of a footing, we we can provide 10 mm reinforcement at 240 mm center to center. So now for this ASP actually not required here, because when we go for check for the shear, maximum shear will be here only in this direction. In this direction, shear will be lesser only, because the moment is less, means obviously why moment is less? Projection is less. And here, why bending moment is maximum more? Projection is more here. So that's why bending moment is more. So if it is safe against one-way shear in this direction, obviously in this direction it will be safe. So no need to calculate twice for short span and the long span as a shear check. So that's why for a column footing, we have two types of checks, one-way shear and two-way shear. One-way shear is generally provided along the shorter span. So that one-way shear critical section is, as I told, so this section will be at a distance D from the face of the column. At this particular section, we have to get the shear force and you have to check for the shear stresses. If it is safe, then whatever the depth you are provided, that will be the safe. Otherwise, if stresses are on higher side, if that stress tau B and tau C, what we find, if tau C is greater than tau B, then it is safe. If tau B is greater than tau C, then what is your comment? Shear reinforcement is required. But here, shear reinforcement generally we don't provide in a footing. The alternate way is we have to increase the depth only. So if you increase the depth, stresses will come down. So in the footing, only the option is we have to increase the depth of the footing. If it is unsafe, it is safe, then no problem. You can just you can give a comment. It is safe design. So here, as I told, there are two checks. One-way shear check and two-way shear check. And in most of the cases, if it is safe against one-way shear, 99.99% it will be safe against the two-way shear check. But as a part of calculation, you should do that two-way shear check. So that will do it now. So now AST, actually we had got it for the shorter span. Okay, so for this, it is not required, because we are here is the critical AST or the shear. So for short span, definitely it will be lesser stresses, because the area is more, so stress will come down. Here the area is less, stresses will be on higher side. So that's why one-way shear check along the shorter direction we are going to do it. So once you have this AST calculation, next check for one-way shear, next subheading, check for one-way shear. Check for one-way shear. The critical section is taken. Critical section is taken at a distance D, small d. At a distance D, away from the face of the column, at a distance D, away from the face of the column, as shown in figure, as shown in following figure, you write down, as shown in following figure. So now you put this sketch, but you don't represent this XX and YY axis. You don't represent this XX and YY axis. You show the footing, what you have provided, the footing size, that is 3.7 meters by 1.85 meters. Then the column size is given 300 by 600. Then the critical section, you show this critical section as say 1-1. You can just give an axis for the critical section as 1-1, which is at a distance D. So D is equal to 680 mm. As per our provision, what we are provided. D provided is 680 mm. So from here, from the face of the column, the critical section will be at a distance of D. You show this critical section 1-1, and this portion you just hatch it. So now I want the shear at this particular section, critical section. So I'll call it as shear force VU, factored. I'll just put directly factored because I know the PU value, the factored stress. I know it. So at this section, if I want the shear, so this, whatever the area into the pressure will give the force, because the general expression is stress is equal to P by A. This is a general expression for the force. So this P is nothing but the shear force. So if I want this P is equal to stress into area, if I rearrange the terms, if I want the force, it is stress into area. So the same concept I'm going to apply here. To get the shear force, nothing but the P will be the shear force. I'll just rearrange this as, this will be the shear force, that is VU. Stress. Stress is what? The soil pressure which is induced at the base of the foundation. So that PU value. So PU into, and whatever this PU is there, it is per meter square, is it? So whatever the PU value we had worked out, it is, I think, 200 and something PU value. It is kilonewton per meter square, is it? The soil pressure. But here, whatever the stress is there, we have to make it to per meter. Because whatever this stress we are finding, if I just apply the basic concept, if I take this as a cantilever portion, this is a cantilever portion of the footing, and here I have the pressure, soil pressure, which is acting in the upward direction. And this intensity is 263.15 kilonewton per meter square. And if I want to have the pressure per meter, because I want the shear force, so this has to be multiplied by for how much width the pressure has been distributed. So here, how much width it is distributed for a width B. So here, this PU into B will give the intensity of loading here per meter. So it is just reverse. Cantilever, we take load downward. Here, pressure is acting in the upward direction. But the effect is the same. It is cantilever effect. So here, this will give per meter, the pressure or the load intensity per meter, PU into B. This is in kilonewton per meter square, B is in meter. Then it will be, when I multiply with this into meter, so this meter and this will get cancels. We are left with kilonewton per meter. So this is stress into area. What is the area? This area, which is equal to, so this width, how much this width? This will be, if I put in terms of L and B, D value, it is L minus capital D divided by 2 minus D, is it? This hatching portion width is total L minus D divided by 2, means from the face to this edge. Now I want this only. So that minus the d distance. So this into the width b. Just go for the calculation. This means is only one b will come here. This kilonewton per meter square shear force. No, it is just only once. You don't go with two times. Only once b you multiply. So your vu is equal to p into, that is pu into b into bracket L minus D divided by 2 minus D. So use this formula for shear force. It is 263.15 into 2. So it is kilonewton per meter square is there. So then you have to convert this into B is 1.85. You put it in terms of meters only, so that you'll get VU in terms of kilonewton. So L is 3.7 minus 0.6 divided by 2. This minus 0.68. So VU is equal to 435.71. It is kilonewton, because here this PU is in terms of kilonewton per meter square. This is in meter, this all get cancelled. So finally you will get with kilonewton, you left with kilonewton, the shear force, factored shear force. So once you get the factored shear force, you have to go for nominal shear stress, that is tau v. Once you get this shear force, that is factored shear force, then the nominal shear stress, tau v is equal to vu by b into d. So here b is capital B, because for this much of width, we have to find the stress. So it's equal to 435.71. So now if I make it to Newton, it is 10 to the power of 3 divided by B is 1850 mm. Depth is 680 mm. So it will be Newton per mm square. Nominal shear stress. Just check with this 0.33 or 32 or 34. 0.33. So tau v, we got it. Now we want tau c, that is design shear stress. So for that you have to refer IS 456-2000 for AST provided, that is PT. So here the percent of steel provided. So here AST provided is 1386.63, actually AST provided. So you go for PT value, the percentage of steel provided, PT, percentage of steel provided. So PT is equal to 100, AST provided is 1386.63 divided by, so B is here 1000 only, because here whatever this ASP provided is 4 meter width spacing you are provided. So here B value is 1000, don't put again 1850. So here whatever this steel is provided, it is 4 meter width. So here B value is 1000 only, B into D, 680. So how much percentage? 0.2. So 0.2%. So refer IS 456-2000. That is table number 19, I think. Is it 19? Table number 19 and get the value of tau C value. Design shear stress. For M20 grade concrete. Table number 19, I think. For table number 19, PT is 0.2. Means you have to interpolate between 0.15 and 0.25. And 0.36. 0.28. So it will be between, I think, 0.28 and 0.36. In between that one, you have to interpolate. 0.32. So your tau C value is equal to 0.32 Newton per mm square. This is referring table 19 of IS 456-2000. So by referring table number 19, tau C value is 0.32 Newton per mm square and your tau V value is 0.33. It is very marginal, unsafe we can say. Marginality is unsafe. Because tau V is 0.33 Newton per mm square and tau C is 0.32. So 0.01 difference is there, Newton per mm square. So practically it would be safe because we have factor of safety, sufficient factor of safety, partial safety factors. Since the margin is very negligible here, 0.01 Newton per mm square. So we can say it is, since the difference is very negligible, it is safe. Or if you want clear safe, then you have to revise the section. So instead of 680 what you had provided, you make it to 700. Or slightly more than, say, even if you put, I think, 690 mm, the effective depth, your stress will come down. Because this will increase this depth, so sorry here, tau V value. When you work out this nominal shear stress, instead of 680, if you make it to 690, if you increase the depth of the footing, if this is increasing means, this will come down. So instead of 0.33, you may end up with say 0.31 or 0.3. And here it will be 0.32 design shear stress for the same percent of steel because we are not changing the steel. So this 0.32 is based on this percentage. So we are not changing the percentage of steel. So your tau C value will be the same. Depth will be increased. So since here marginally difference is there, you can make it safe. Otherwise you have to go with again recalculating of ASC. Again you have to calculate ASC with 690 as depth. In that case it will be still safer because what happens, your ASC will change slightly here because it will come down, ASC will be lesser. because you are providing more depth. If you more depth means steel required will be less. So here we can say it is marginal difference is there, it is safe. So it is safe against one way shear. If it is unsafe, then only the option is you have to increase the depth. If the margin is more, then you have to revise the section. So this is regarding the one way shear check. So any clarification regarding this one way shear check? So here we can put the comment, since tau b is almost equal to tau c, tau b is almost equal to tau c, hence safe against one way shear. Hence safe against one way shear. So next we'll go for two way shear check. So for the two way shear check, as the name indicates, two way shear check in both the direction, in the long span as well as the short span, we should have a critical section for the shears. And as per the code, for a two way shear check, your critical section will be at a distance of d by 2 from the face of the column. As we have at a distance d for one way shear check, the critical section all round the column . So whatever this dotted line I had represented, that is the critical section for two way shear check. And this distance is d by 2, this distance is again d by 2, again this distance is d by 2, this distance is d by 2, all round the column at a distance of d by 2, your critical section is going to lie. Two-way shear check. Next subheading you write down. Timer. Okay, so tomorrow we will have the open book assignment test. It will be after your regular class. I think after that you don't have the classes. Lab is there. 1 to 2, I have the regular class only. So I don't want to lose that class, that's why. I think Saturday is Tuesday's timetable. So Tuesday we have at 1 to 2. So after that you are free. Again on that day, Tuesday also lab. No, Saturday is not possible because I have duty, test duty I have. So Saturday is not possible because higher semester tests are there. So we'll have tomorrow only. Tomorrow 1 to 2 we'll have. 1 to 2 in our regular class only. And the portion is, as I told, T-beam design and design. You get the books and it is open book, na? You can refer the books and you can design it. It is open book assignment is there, so books are with you. You just search for that and you design that if it is asked. So T-beam and one more, which one I told? Slab? Two-way slab I told. So two-way slab and T-beam design will be there for the open book assignment tomorrow at 1 o'clock.